think we'll ever have kids.
One day, I suppose.
Kind of thought we could stay in here.
All day.
Let's have another baby.
Try not to let it get to me. We'll see them. Together.
Aren't you supposed to be in Australia?
I changed my mind. Couldn't be asked.
Everybody's doing a brand new dance.
Oh, Stephen!
Katie! Katie! Come on, love, you haven't got work this afternoon. Well, it's your decision, but I'm visiting your mum with or without you. And this is the second time you've jibbed her, and I'm not making any more excuses, all right? But you know she'll be disappointed. I'm leaving in 5 minutes.
Have you heard that new dance track by Puff Daddy? Or is it P. Diddy? It's P. Summer, anyway. Penis. I think it rocks me.
I think you should stick to hip-hop.
Oh, you're getting boring in your old age. Hey, that's an idea, though. Maybe we should go on holiday for a week, somewhere hot and happening.
Happening?
Yeah, you know, clubby like a beaver, what do you reckon?
Whatever.
You deserve it, you do, for being such a good girl.
Suppose it'd be nice.
I'll grab some brochures this week. Classy ones. Lump Polly. Right. I wonder how your old mum's doing today.
Jack really needs to rethink his match day tactics.
Pudgies! Paul's over there.
What?
It still freaks me out when I think about it. I mean, that's it, she's dead. And you see him wandering about. Just gets you thinking, what's going on in his head?
No, I know what you mean.
Hey, Stella's, please, love.
Go act normal for this thing.
I wanted Guinness.
Where's Katie?
She didn't want to come.
Why not?
Not in the mood.
Don't blame her. We never beat Chelsea.
I might have a pill, actually. It's ages since I've been off my head at the match. What have you got?
Nothing.
What time are you turning up, then?
They're not. I'm knocking all that on the head.
Love is in the air.
Now, Jane's forcing him on this straight and narrow.
She's not. I just decided it was time to try a proper job again.
And have you got one?
Not yet, but I will.
Until you get sacked.
You'd get sacked from going to the job centre.
So who's sorting us out later?
Matt Bosnich.
Seriously, though?
I'm not out. Going round Jane's later watching Ant and Dec.
I'm talking about drugs and you're talking about Ant and Dec.
Do you know her dad's been in the eye hospital this week? With his eyes?
Not with his legs. I'm out. No gay, though.
Got a pass.
Who from? Don't need one, mate.
Yeah, it must be love. What about you?
Driven here. Want to try and get to the cemetery before it goes dark. Not been to see her today. It's nearly 6 weeks since we put her in the ground now. Can you believe that? Maybe you'd all like to come with me.
Please don't be asking me if your bum looks big in it.
I know. It's just that I'm meeting Ray later, so I wanted to look a bit smart. But everything I've got just looks, well, like this.
Who's Ray?
Bank manager.
Ray, eh?
I'm after another loan for this house I've seen.
Another one?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you buy yourself a suit? Shell out a bit on it.
Don't know. It takes me 9 to 5, don't they? People like David Brent or Ray.
To see you in Armani, your boss. Wow.
You reckon?
Yeah. I always thought you looked like a scally James Bond type.
I've always thought you look like Pushy a lot.
Me and your boyfriend.
Paul?
Yeah, your boyfriend.
Not sure we're that official.
You have sex with him?
What's he told you?
Oh, everything. Don't worry, you got a decent mark.
I'm not. Certain things I know I'm good at.
Guess what I've got?
No brain.
A job. You proud of me, what?
What?
You're in?
Accident insurance.
One call, that's all.
That's great.
Hello? Press me. I'm clean. Just say no. Thought I'd take you out. Something to eat. An Italian.
Pizza up.
Yeah, right. However, I do know a place that does a sumptuous cheesy crust.
Oh, you two have a great time.
Jane, you one lucky girl. Did it then?
Well done. Yeah, I see what you mean now.
Like it?
Love it. This is gorgeous.
Great for cocaine. That's what swung it.
Your mum wasn't worth this much, was she?
Those brass camels she had were worth a fortune. She had a policy. Cashed in nicely when she died.
Well, Eileen had a policy.
Yeah, I know. I was dead surprised and all.
Oh, she probably just didn't want to worry you. Why don't you buy a house?
Well, you can't get an house with a view like that. Anyway, I've got enough squirreled away. For a deposit if I want. So in the meantime, I'm happy renting. Could do what Carl does if I wanted. Oh, and I've been accepted on a course at Manchester Met. Thought you might find that interesting.
Not computers and finance, I hope.
Film studies. I get to study the history of film. How good's that?
It's great. But why?
I've always been into films, haven't I? So I thought, if I'm going to study anything, it's going to be something I'm into. I mean, really into. As they didn't do a degree on being a hardcore drug fiend, I hoped to for that. Instead, went for an interview, charmed the socks off them, laid a few Hitchcock references down. They offered me a place, mature student. Not sure about the mature bit, but at least I'm in.
That's fantastic. I'm so impressed. This place is so not you. Wasn't it you that said something like, anyone who lives in town is a wannabe London cocksucker?
And I was right. Then, I've changed, haven't I? Australia's opened my mind, made me more open to things. I even understand the point of coffee shops now. You know, the ones that don't sell weed. I'm being honest, then. I've changed. Different. And this place, you're right. Before it wasn't me. But now, I could get used to it.
You're right, you have changed. Everyone seems to be changing but me.
Maybe that's because everyone needed to change except you. Anyway, cheers.
Cheers.
Really feel different about this job. You know what I mean? Because I can stick to it. No more selling drugs for me. Mugs game. Thank you for that.
What?
Sorting me head out. Without you, I would have just carried on.
I've been nicked.
Exactly. You're a star. But to me, you are. And I'm really glad that, you know, we're together.
I knew it was the famous opera house, but then again, it looks like Oxford Road train station. I've pissed on that before. Right, so I get me cock out. Right, and...
Pint of lager, please, Jack. Keep change.
Ticked.
All right, you too. See you there. Do you want a drink?
Can we start, please?
White wine, spritzer and all, please. What do you reckon? I might need it.
Why?
Bank manager shit. Got another house, what about it? I thought it was about time I'm up the park.
And the tub's out of Miami Vice.
Have you tried the garlic dip? How do you feel about your flat at the moment?
What do you mean?
Is it big enough? Do those lads get on your nerves, you know? Are you happy there? It's just, with this job, I'll be able to get my own place, eventually. And I was wondering, well, hoping...
I'm sorry, Paul. I don't think this is working for me.
I know these cheesy crusts do get a bit samey. Should have gone with the normal deep pan. You don't mean the pizzas, do you? I mean, not working. Is it something I can fix? Because it's working great for me.
I think you can fix it for me.
I thought you liked me.
I do. I think you're great.
Just not great enough.
Spot. It's not you, it's me.
Fucking hell, I've heard that one before.
I know it's lame way of putting it, but it's true.
So what's the matter with me then?
Nothing. It's just...
In fact, save it.
Paul? Paul! Come on, Paul, I'm being honest. Don't leave like this.
How do you expect me to leave? You want me to sit there and talk about how I'm not good enough? Well, I'm sorry, I don't. I really like you, Jane. Loads. I never felt like this about anyone before. So thanks a lot.
You two fancy getting out of here? Quiz night down the church or something?
We can't.
Call our team the Bermuda Triangle. Nice suit, mate.
You two swapping fashion tips?
I got a shim of pinks, you know, like a posh curry house in town.
So posh, posh goes there.
So we thought we'd get dressed up, you know.
Posh. So it's full of wankers then?
Well, I think you both look great. I'm with you there.
Well, we just did it for a bit of a laugh, really.
Yeah, you look like a joke.
Back go. Table's booked. You haven't got time.
Come with us.
No, thanks.
It's only a colleague at the end of the day.
Yeah, well, at the end of the day, when all's said and done. No.
Embarrassing is your dad.
We've just been to see that film, haven't we? You know, that comedy.
Well, you'll have to narrow it down.
It was dead funny. It was laughing me cock off. Well, she's a big girl now, aren't you? Are you hungry? I'm starving.
Just had sushi.
You had sushi? I watched a load of plates going round in circles. It's time for some meat. Stuff that goes brown when you cook it. Where's Mars? Do you fancy how I'll go up and order?
Well, no, she'll be over in a bit. Has he had too many fizzy drinks today? Everything all right?
Yeah. I think so.
He just seems weird.
He is weird. Plus, he has had a bit of an excuse recently.
Nah, it's more than that. Have you not noticed how hyper he is? Poor Kate, he looks exhausted.
And to be honest, I think he's been coping well. You know, keeping upbeat.
Upbeat? Just a bit too upbeat. You know, not natural, like he's on a load of whiz or something.
No, you don't reckon.
Nah.
Well, all we can do is let him know we're here. I'm constantly reminding him of his responsibilities to Katie, to his family, to us. You know, just in case. I've said to him, just because you've lost Tina, it's no excuse for losing the plot again.
I think we should remind him again.
What do you think of it, then?
How much was it?
150.
Bargain. Nice, though.
It is, isn't it?
So when Pat said he'd like to take me away, I was expecting a dirty weekend in Wales or week in Gran Canaria tops. And then he brings on these brochures for Koh Samui and the Maldives. What do you think?
What?
Thailand or Wales?
Go wherever you want to go.
You're not really here, are you, sat at this table?
I'm just really bored of this place. What am I doing here?
Earning, helping people.
I want more. Get knocked down by the bus tomorrow.
Yes, you could. Or a moped. Or a big road sweeper.
Just keep thinking about Tina. You know what? It takes something like that to give you a good kick up the arse. Make you realise that life's too short. All we do is sit here and moan.
Hello?
Andy, it's Jane.
All right?
I was
trying... What can I do for you?
Sorry.
Sorry.
You first.
No, you first.
You rang me.
So?
So? I haven't really got anything to say, nothing in particular, anyway.
Okay, then.
Okay, then what?
Do you fancy going out for a drink sometime?
I fancy going out for a drink all the time. Hang on. You mean just you and me?
That would be the plan.
You asking me out?
Sort of.
Sort of?
Yeah, I'm asking you out.
All right.
What about Paul?
We finished the other night.
Fast worker, eh? We or you finished it?
Does it matter?
Trust me, it matters.
I finished it.
Oh, that'll explain his moodiness.
You've probably broken his heart, you do realise.
I didn't mean to, it's just that
I won't go out with you, Jane.
What?
I won't go out with you.
Because of Paul?
And other things. Basically Paul, yeah.
Oh, right, it's just a thought.
Sorry, it's wrong.
You obviously feel very strongly about it.
You wouldn't believe. I'll still see you around,
though. No?
Yeah, I'll see you around.
Bye, then.
Bye. Come on, Carl, I'm nearly there.
It's all right, it's me.
It's all right, I'm safe.
Safe?
Carl.
I'm coming, don't worry.
Sigh.
We're just saying that, you know, we're still here.
I know. How are you both doing? Are you all right?
You just seemed a bit lively when we met the other day. A bit hyper.
That must have been the grammar whiz act. Oh, come on, you two. Of course I'm a bit hyper, I've got to be. Katie needs to see me bouncing. I'm doing it for her. I mean, don't get me wrong. I appreciate you being here for me and all that. But the special chats, they're not needed. Stop worrying.
Right. Special chat over them. Want another?
It's all right. I'll get them. 3 pints, please, love.
I don't know. I'm not convinced.
There's definitely something up. I haven't seen him that keen to get around him for years.
Excuse me, where are the payphones?
Just over there.
Oh, thanks. I've been waiting for this eye operation for 18 months now. Pay for him to go private if I could. I'm surprised he's not killed himself already.
It's you, my mum, I'm worried about.
It's my dad, Carl. I love him. And he's going blind. So if you can't find any sympathy for him, at least try and find some for me.
Sorry.
Oh, have you got any facts, love?
Where are you going?
For lunch.
Canteen's this way.
Yeah, I know. But it's a lovely day, isn't it? Coming.
Sure you don't want one?
Diet Coke, please. You get sacked for that.
I'll go get us a couple of menus, yeah?
What are you doing now?
Going in.
Do you do better sculpting when you pissed?
Lots of creative juices flow, yeah? How's Paul?
He'll get over it.
You know, I'm sorry if it's caused any friction. No, he's your mate and everything.
Me? You can go out with and finish with whoever you like. It's a free country. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. You're not biking out, are you, to school?
No, I'll get a bus. I'll flag a taxi.
Right. Yeah. For a taxi.
I'm all right.
You buy yourself some tins of beans then or something.
Thanks, bruv.
It's all right, sis. What have you been thinking?
Liar.
Your dad's operation. You said he could have it done private.
He can. I can't. It's about £2,000.
I can afford that at the moment.
You? Pay that for my dad?
Well, we're not best mates or anything, but I don't want to see the bloke go blind. Especially as I can see how much it means to you and me mum.
Oh, God, I fucking love you.
Is this legal?
I'm going to tell him right now. He'll be over the moon. So will your mum.
Pissed up more like. Just tell your dad not to go for a celebratory drive or anything.
How you doing?
All right, thanks.
She seems happy. So do you.
Don't laugh. But I really like this old sister thing going on with Jane. I think the big brother role suits me.
Mmm. Beach canteen, innit? Mm. Fancy another drink? Mummy, back go. Chicken. Here. Sort out your booze breath. What are you doing now? I'll see you later, yeah? What about work? It's time to stop moaning.
Set them up. How's Paul?
Devastated.
Still?
She broke his arm.
And?
And he's your mate, so you should care.
Well, if it wasn't right for what she's supposed to do, fucking for charity.
Yeah, well, you would say that.
What does that mean?
It means you would say that. So what if I went out with Jane and broke her heart? That'd be all right as well.
Just set them up.
It wasn't in the contract that I was the donor all the bleeding time.
student wankers.
Hiya.
Hello.
It's me.
So it is.
Listen, that phone conversation we had.
The one where I asked you out and you said no.
See, I knew it. I knew we had cross wires. When I said I won't go for a drink with you, I meant I won't go for a drink with you tonight. And I really couldn't then. Really, I was washing my hair. But tonight... Tonight I'd love to have a drink with you. Look, you can go wherever you want. The park, a local bus stop, wander the streets aimlessly singing football songs. But no, I'll let you decide.
How about here?
Here?
Sat on the steps?
Sat on the steps is great. Wonder why I didn't think of that.
One for you.
And one for me. Cheers.
Hello? Hiya, Mum. Yeah, she's fine. She's asleep. No, I'm all right. Honest.
Oh, Big Brother beating me up, don't I?
No, you don't.
Have I missed something here?
Yeah, my ovaries. I haven't seen you for ages.
And I've asked for your fucking sympathy.
Good, because I want you out of here by the end of the week.
If he's to remain my boyfriend, then he's got to do as I say. No questions. What's the matter with you?
Nothing!
Maybe you should stay there tonight.
Maybe I will.
Right, I'll see you then!